Today is International Women's Day, which aims to celebrate women's positive achievements. But 40 years since the birth of Women's Lib, journalist Janet Street Porter has said there's little to celebrate. Writing in the Mail today, she says many young women have pretty dubious role models today, pop stars and models who celebrate conspicuous consumption. Worrying new statistics show a generation of young mums with no jobs, no money and no partners who are following a pattern set down by their own mums and even their grandmothers. All a bit depressing. So do you agree with Ms. Street Porter? Have our lives progressed since our mother's generation? Or do we think we've got it so good and we haven't?
I think mine has, but I have to just hop back to my mother, because I always admire my mother, because my mother was a model and a fantastic model, and she was a ballroom dancer and brilliant at that. And my mother was, in a way, born too soon, because if she'd have been now, she'd have been doing this. You know, she had such determination. She was very talented. But she had my brother and myself, and then, you know, you stopped. And she stopped work and had us. She created a fantastic life for us, and she was a great support and very determined that we would go on and have our own careers, and was determined for that. But in a way, I'd like her to have been now, because she would have had that, you know, she would have really had, she'd have been a ballroom dancer still, she'd have still been a model, she'd have done other things. And so I've learnt from that, and I've taken from that, and I hope that I've made her proud by being the person that she was and she's made me into, and a strong woman, and gone on to have my own career. And I've got that from my mother, and I wouldn't be what I am without her. So I learnt that, and that's what I hope that I can teach my daughter. And so that's how you pass it on. But not everybody has that chance or all that kind of background.
Mum, your mum was a trained opera singer,
wasn't she? Professional singer, yeah. She was a trained opera singer, and then when she met my dad, she joined him on the big band circuit, because my dad was a big band, so. And then when we came along, obviously, she didn't have to give it kind of up straight away, because we all joined the act, so she carried on singing. Yeah. You know, the Von Trapps. But then she did. I mean, it got to a point then where, when we moved to London, they decided just the girls should continue, and then she stopped. But the thing about my mum is her kids, you know, from the firstborn right down to me, became her life. So she actually wanted to be at home then
and
for her kids.
She resented that.
No, not at all, because I think she lived her life kind of through us. She enjoyed everything that we went on to achieve, and she loved that, and I loved the fact, to be fair, that when I was little, whenever I went home, she was there, you know. And I, you know, I sometimes think now, you know, I look at her and think, you know, the pressure's on us now compared to, I mean, we can do more now. And it's acceptable for women to do more now, but I think the pressure is much greater now than it was.
Well, something that we put pressure on ourselves, Carol, don't we? But your mum, does she work when you were growing up?
I think women do now. Yeah, no, she did have to go to work, but she didn't go to work until she could do something whereby she would always be there when we went to school and when we got home. That's why she ended up working in pubs. Yeah, my mum worked in a pub. I know, it's funny, isn't it? But it was the perfect job for her, because it was between 11 and 3. They shut in the afternoon then, so she was always at home. But I do think, in a way, that you say about your mum, that's what women did then, didn't they? They had kids and they gave everything up to bring their kids up. And I'm not sure that it's a good thing. And I think a lot of women are rebelling against the fact that, you know, there has been pressure on women, and they've put it on themselves more than anything, yeah, to have everything and do everything and be good at everything. But you can't be good at everything.
And you've got to guilt.
Exactly, you've got to make your choices. But no, I went completely the opposite way to my mum. And I just remember her standing at the kitchen sink almost her whole life, peeling potatoes. Drudgery it was, just drudgery, with four kids. She was a single mum, but not through choice. You know, she had no choice. She had to deal with it. And I absolutely remember registering that, like, I'm not having that. I'm never going down that road. And I kind of just scooted off in the opposite direction, and that's exactly what I do. I'm the total opposite of my mum. She never travelled. I travel all the time. She had four kids. I don't want kids. You know, there's all these things, and you know,
but
my two sisters did follow.
Don't we? That's
we have too many choices.
Yeah, but I think it's fantastic that we have the choices. Our mothers didn't, you know, have the choice, like you said about your mum. I mean, my mum joined the Wrens, so you know, she was in the Navy. Then she met my dad, who was in the Army. But she said to me, in those days, there was no question about which one of us is going to give up work. It was always the woman, and they didn't resent it then. It's almost like we resent it now because we've worked hard for our careers.
Yeah, but we have to,
and it's made life harder, I think.
But the difference is now is that two people have to work and they have to earn because it's a different world now. Mm. You can't, you know, you haven't got the luxury of a husband looking after you.
Milkman's here.
You know, you haven't got that luxury now to stay at home. You know, you both have to work and both have to earn because that's the world we live in. That's gone.
Yeah.
That's what's sad.
It is, but, you know, that's we've kind of strived for equality in the workplace, haven't we? And then this is kind of what's happened.
And for a certain lifestyle as well, which people don't want to give up. So that's a lot.
I don't think we could go back, could you?
No.
To women not having those opportunities. Well, interesting. I'd like to know what you think of.